Hey guys, what's up? It's Harrison again. Welcome back to part four, part three of the FNAF lore. And I'm thinking that there might be more than five parts. I've got a lot to cover through. I wrote a massive story just so I could write it out for you guys. So let's get into it. We left off last time with Slick Willy over here, and he is not a single father free, as we already know. It was a question that I had never considered until the answer practically slapped me in the face while reading. In the text, Scott draws a very clear contrast between Funtime Freddy's voice and the one belonging to Baby and Ballora. He says that Funtime Freddy's audio seems pre-recorded and relates to kids and birthday parties, unlike Ballora's and Circus Baby, which is more complex. It's an interesting detail for Scott to call out that I honestly never considered. Ballora is much more aware of her surroundings, responding in real-life movements in her room, chamber, not seeming to reply to pre-recorded lines. I can hear someone creeping through my room. It seems more than just a coincidence that the only other robot to have that feature is one that we know that has Aftlin's daughter inside of it. But up to now, we've all thought that Ballora is just some bizarre new character. But is it possible that she has a bigger part in this than we all thought? This is far from speculation. Another major clue hides inside her song. The lyrics go, "Why do you hide inside your walls when there is music in your walls? All I see is an empty tomb, no more joy, an empty room." That is the kind of language that you'd hear from a parent that had just lost a child, with the child's bedroom acting as some sort of tomb, reminding them of their loss. Could it be that this song is referencing to the daughter's empty room that we just talked about in FNAF 4? And if that's the case, does that make Ballora's true identity Mrs. Afton? She is motherly in a way, as the many reasons as her child, and she's much older and mature looking animatronic. With that, another Afton buried in the basement, 1983. Only three now stand, the crying child, older brother Michael, the face of William, one gets bit, one gets scooped, and one gets sprung. I don't know, it sounds kind of bad. Regardless, the debate of whether Michael or William is the true purple guy when the kid springs up is into my next chapter of the FNAF lore. Thank you guys, sorry that was a short video. I'll make sure to get a bunch in the next video. Make sure to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell for more FNAF lore videos. Next one, bye.